right, so I'm going to do some chainsawing today with a regular chainsaw and with a pole chainsaw. Cutting along the fence line at my friend John and Mondi Wooten's, one of their two farms. So this is driving in. A lot of avocados on this tree. There's been a green lace bug that's been attacking the avocados. Fortunately, they have dozens of varieties, and some of the avocados aren't completely getting their asses kicked. Boy, that tree is not looking super vibrant, but the avos on it look awesome. You can see he's got his hydration, or irrigation rather, strung from tree to tree. There's a lot of coconuts. See, those are chikus there. Chiku tree, chiku fruits, kind of like a kiwi, except not tangy, sort of sweet brown sugary. This is chocolate sapote, I think. And here's a soursop tree. I don't know if you can, there's a little teeny tiny soursop. I'll see if I can zoom in on it. Maybe you can see some of the fruits on this tree. Yeah, kind of really spiky looking. Those are small, immature soursops. Get to be about the size of a cantaloupe roughly, and very anti-cancer kind of fruit. Strangely enough, the pawpaw is a cousin to it. They're a Southeast Asian fruit though, the soursops. Just acres and acres and acres and acres of trees. So this is driving along the initial border of the property. Oh, there's some more soursops on this one. Soursops are just fantastic. You get a nice ripe one. You get a nice ripe soursop and put it in the fridge overnight and eat it. It's got a lot of seeds and this and that, but you know, kind of a messy fruit, but oh my God, they're just like the best sherbet you've ever had. Tangy and sweet. So good and ultra healthy for you. Some avocado trees in the background, and I think that's chocolate sapote again. Here's another soursop tree. There's some immature fruit right there. Right there. A couple hanging right here. Yeah, that tree's loaded up pretty nicely. Oh, here's a starfruit tree. Oh, I might just have to pick one of those right now and have a little snack. Yeah, definitely. What a great time to stop the truck. Oh, get out for a little closer look and a taste. Let's see, which one is screaming for me to pick it? This one's got some rot on it, so you know it's good and tasty because it's ultra ripe and the bugs are eating it. But I might be a little more discriminating and maybe get one that isn't quite so ripe, but let's see. I'm going to grab this one with a bad bottom and just eat the top half of it. Well, I don't know. It's got quite a bit of ants crawling on it and stuff. Maybe I'll be a bit more discriminating. Grab this guy right here. Thank you, John. Thank you, Nandi. Thank you, Starfruit Tree. Oh, man, the ants are grinding on it. You know it's good. So, maybe I'll do another couple few little videos of what's going on today out here with me. This is a dwarf coconut. You know, it's awesome to be able to pick coconuts and drink coconut water from them and eat the coconut flesh, but it kind of sucks to have to go 20, 30, 40 feet into the air to get your coconuts. So the answer is these dwarf coconut trees or Samoan coconut trees. This one isn't throwing any fruit yet, but it's just the right height. Couple of John's tractors over there, and another row, roadway row. Here's another avocado tree that's looking okay, man. He grows the best avocados. That's really one of his specialties, is growing avos. Now, what's going on with this tree here? Oh, it's kind of crazy looking. It looks to me like an avocado tree, but I don't know what's going on. Some of the fruit are like rotting and immature. You know, it's not easy being a farmer. He's done it for 30 years. You know, you can grow a crop, and first time you grow it, have great luck. But it's the second time you try to grow it, or the third time, or the 22nd, or the 23rd time, can you consistently grow something? A lot of people have beginner's luck, and then the second time they try to grow it, whew, not so much. You can see what the green lace bug is doing to this avocado tree. It's not super virile. And then another one. John's kind of optimistic that hopefully the green lace bug will be wiped out by some other predator species of insect, and the avocado trees will ultimately survive. Of course, some of them are going to go down. Some of them are going to get wiped out. That's inevitable. That's why he has dozens, if not hundreds, of avocado trees. And he's grown a lot of other things.